Writing a text file in Java is exactly like writing to the console with system.out.println, except you have to do some more setup. In the class WriteSimpleFile, we have a static method selectTextFile that will allow the user to pick a file using a dialog box. The JFileChooser class allows us to display a file save dialog, just like you'd see in any other application. First, we create an object of the JFileChooser class. Next, we want to look for files ending in .txt or .java, so we create a file name extension filter object and set that to be the filter for the object chooser. We display the dialog by calling chooser's showSaveDialog method. We pass null as a parameter because we don't have a GUI window. Running the program, we see that this displays a normal file save dialog, showing only Java and text files, and allows us to either select save or cancel. Looking back at the code, we see that showSaveDialog returns a value, indicating whether we selected save or cancel. If the return value is equal to the constant approve option, then we have entered a file name and attempt to create and return a print stream with the chosen file. If not, the user selected cancel, and we simply return null. It's possible that the user might type in an invalid file name, for example, a non-existent directory or read-only file name. In that case, a file not found exception will be thrown when we try to create the scanner. We catch that exception and display an error dialog using a static method in the JOptionPane class. Note that for a static method, we use the name of the class .nameOfMethod and don't first have to create a JOptionPane object. The do while true loop guarantees we will keep displaying the file save dialog until either the user enters a valid file name or picks cancel. Now let's look at the main method for this class. Before calling the selectTextFile method, we set the look and feel for the application to the system look and feel. This way, the file open dialog looks like the ones in other applications on your system, rather than the Java cross-platform dialog. We use the static method setLookAndFeel in the UIManager class to accomplish this, passing it the result of the static method getSystemLookAndFeel class name. Since setLookAndFeel might throw an exception, although not with the parameter we passed, we are required to enclose it in a try-catch block. We then call selectTextFile. If it doesn't return null, we'll write a short haiku to the file using println on the output stream. This is just like calling system.out.println, except we use the object output stream instead of the object system.out. As with system.out, we could output ints or doubles or strings or any other object. Once we're done, we close the file. The file would be closed automatically when the program finished, but it is a good habit to get into for the times we might want to write a file and read it later in the same program. We'll now run the file and enter a valid file name. Opening that file in Notepad, you'll see that it's written the haiku to the file.